Hello and welcome, my good friends. Sepp Waldenberg, together with Susanne Williams. Thanks for joining us. And I thought on a few ideas, but not on the ice pick. You know, if you're crossing a frozen lake and you fall into the water, you cannot grab anything because it's slippery. Mm. But with this, with the glove snare,
ice picks,
you could came out.
You could do it. You could totally do it.
So, I got a bunch of new items and each one deserves a complete video, but I show them all in this video because I get them all nearly to the same time and it was like Christmas for me. We will show you from Doc Forgay this awesome outdoor survival bushcraft medicine book. A bunch of handcrafted new items, and this item started with my peanut tin cup because my good friend Stefan, thank you very much from the East Sea, saw this and said
he couldn't stand it. He couldn't stand it.
He's
drinking it.
We will bring this to the garbage, of course. But yeah, he made these wonderful cups and the hobo stove, and yeah,
amazing.
We are going through it, and this Butterfold leather couch. He made this pouch. Okay, Tischklopf. And
yes.
Tim, impressive, made this awesome tools. He made a new series of his awesome, nice Tinderkeep with ferro rod and strike and so on in it, with stabilizer here. The one we have didn't break, but
that's
he even
Tim.
Made it better, or a new smile, a new style with a smile, no? Tinderkeep with a smile on it, extra ferro rod.
Nice.
Yeah. And this, I like it so much, again from Stefan. We start with Stefan. He made this giant toothpicks, Spieße, Schaschlikspieße, was heißt
Skewers.
Out of bicycle
spokes.
Spokes,
yes.
Yeah. Spurs out of spokes. And I like them really much. And I called him on the telephone and said thanks, and he had an awesome idea. He said you easily could make, with a longer stick of course, a fish or frog spear out of them. The little critter.
Yeah, because it's got this 90-degree stable angle on it, right?
Yeah, and so you will not lose them here, and yeah.
Make a frog gig, yes.
Yes.
Definitely.
Or anything. Against
vampires.
Yeah, for example. Huh?
If the wood doesn't work, try the steel.
Yeah. Super. Yeah. And of course, what is this? Spieße?
Skewer.
Yeah, okay. A couple of them out of this bicycle.
Spoke. Yeah.
Skewers, spokes, and spikes, and whatever. Nice.
Yeah, I like it. It's such good steel as well.
Absolutely.
Really good steel.
From the upcycling, a super idea from an old broken bicycle. So we have six of these tent bags, and I really look forward if I build the next time my Bashbalatka canvas poncho tent, two of these half tents together, and mount them with these awesome tent bags. And you can go in the Öse.
Yeah, in the grommet.
Give them here. This good knot will hold them, and stick it into the ground.
Fantastic.
Yeah. Really well thought. An awesome made, and out of a baby child bed, those beechwood sticks.
Wow!
You know those tiny jails for babies.
Yeah. Crib.
So the baby will fall out, but tent pegs are important.
It's interesting when you look at someone like Dave Canterbury or these guys are always saying you should take four tent pegs.
Yeah.
Of course you can cut them, but they don't weigh anything, and they use these ABS plastic ones, but these are much better.
Mm-hmm.
These are much better.
Yeah,
I like
them. I also prefer tent pegs. Meanwhile, of course, you can carve them, but each time for each tarp, I have a couple of tent pegs with me, and it's done, and I still could carve one. Yes, and out of this baby bed sticks, I made my first successful bow drill. The board was fresh collected Earl wood. And the spindle was exact close to this size from this bed,
really?
The stick.
Wow.
Then he made a hobo stove. Oh, the carabiner was somewhere else in this kit. He made a hobo stove, and these are a smaller one, a great size, fits good with my water bottle. It's not the big size from the Swedish company where you have to build your own furniture with an Allen key. It's special made.
Nice.
With the side grinder, and he made everything so fine and nice and filed it with a Dremel, something like this. Really good.
That's awesome. Yeah.
And this cross here to put it inside. And what's good here, you have air for the flames. If you put it just on this side, you often put out the fire because the flame cannot go somewhere. But here,
everything. That's awesome.
Or even better, the giant one.
Yes.
And this has such a good hope we find everything again. This has such a good bottom.
Oh, it's amazing.
Yeah, and he cut this out of an old and broken hot water bottle. This was a giant hot water bottle. Give out the inside, this insulation stuff. So it's an awesome cooking pot.
Wow. Yeah. And he's worked the edges, these completely round, huh?
Yes.
Absolutely brilliant. Wow.
He works so accurate. Maybe you have seen the back frame he made me, the triangle back frame. Really great. And this small cup, two of the same size, and here to make this or without this, he cut them out of the insulated stainless steel cups. The one you cannot give into the fire because they could break or explode. But he cut them, grinded this, and so you have cups you always can give on the coals or fire. Stefan, we are still with Stefan from the East Sea. He made those cosmetic beds.
With wax. Huh?
No, he uses them, but okay, it's everything allowed in Germany. Now, he gave them in with wax. Sorry.
I think I have to go into the mode now. There we go.
They are complete, filled with wax. And should burn quite a long time. Here he has a cordage. You can open it and use it as tinder bundle.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Like I've been doing with the, I have the same thing.
With natural cordage.
Yeah.
Which he has also inside here in this flint and steel kit. And nice, I never have seen this. He give from a broken bicycle tube, the rubber band, which also would be an excellent fire starter on the metal.
So you can hold it properly.
Absolutely.
What a clever
absolutely
idea.
Absolutely nice.
Wow. That's clever. Ranger bands. That's called a ranger band.
Uh-huh, okay.
Yeah. Or a Snoopy loop. Oh my goodness. Wow.
And
okay.
On the East Sea, he had the chance to find really those flint stones. And yeah.
Now makes a difference, huh?
I have one. The tin has already the hole for making char cloth. He gave in already some char cloth, and from such an old outdoor trouser, this to make new char cloth.
Incredible.
Yeah? Bunch of them.
He thinks of everything. That's
absolutely
awesome.
Yeah.
How satisfying.
He really should make a bushcraft outdoor shop with all his cool gear and ideas.
That's incredible. I like it.
Super nice bag.
Yeah.
this to close it.
Neat.
Tinderkeep has a new set of the Tinderkeep. It's a little more space inside. It's a little bigger diameter and still with this awesome function. Ferro Rod and Striker is inside. Sag ich dann noch. Finest tinder material is inside and the ferro rod which keeps on place to strike on the flat ground should give inside this slot. And this is an awesome idea. Nimm das mal bitte. Mm-hmm. This is a diamond sharpener.
Oh, fantastic. Yes, it is.
For one very cool reason. I did not have thought about this before I knew Tinderkeep.
No way, to sharpen the striker.
To sharpen the striker, yeah, genau. This is sharp on each edge, on each side now, but if you give this in one direction, was hast du denn Grad auf Englisch?
Ridge or edge?
Edge, yeah. You sharpen an edge.
Ridge, maybe?
Ridge, maybe. I don't know, you are from England.
Kinda.
So exact the opposite you like to have from a knife, where you do not like to have this extra edge on the side, but here you get it. This
A burr.
A burr.
A burr.
A burr.
Yes, a burr.
Burr, beer, bear. Damn. How you could keep this all extra. Yeah, nice idea. And with each sharpening stone you can make this, you can sharpen your striker.
Just never occurred to me.
No, yeah, I also have never thought about this.
Much smarter. I like that also the way that he does the strikers, so really just easy to use.
Mm-hmm. It's nearly overpacked with fine tinder materials, so you could give out the half of it and refill it. But yeah, so you get it complete with everything in it. And here something special on it.
Here's mine. So. I like it so much. I like it so much. It's been rainy, rainy, rainy these last days. And I've been very glad of it, I must say.
A friend of mine gave me a few tinder fungus he collected. And on my last course, we burned one the half size of this. And it burned close to 4 hours.
Amazing.
It glued close to 4 hours, so you could use it and make new fire with it to transport fire. The awesome great tinder keep.
The amazing thought.
Yeah, the striker.
The striker.
So, and now to the absolutely best, medicine book I ever read. It's in English, so you could say complicated for me, but it isn't. It's so awesome, easy written and so great to read from a doctor. His biography is awesome. Vietnam veteran and so on.
Hmm.
Family doctor in the US, William W. Forgay, MD.
Hmm.
And I love it. I love it because it does not just say what you have to do in a situation, in a shock and hyperventilation, and I'm not trying it, but it's so awesome, and because I read very, very slow, it would take endless time until I show you the book, and I'm überzeugt, was heißt das?
Convinced? Already convinced by it?
And I'm convinced the rest of it is as good as the first 20 sides, but now I understand why shock has happened, why you hyperventilation, why you do this and what's happened to you and how dangerous it is for diabetic people and so on. And I knew from my courses and first aid courses how to handle shock, but if you have an idea why and what happened into the body, it's much more interesting.
And you don't forget it.
Yes. You understand it better. Yes. That is the point.
Yeah.
It's awesome. I like to say the book is kind of old fashioned. It's brand new. Yeah. The items here, everything is brand new. The rain is brand new.
Mm.
But I like it from the complete style, from how to find everything, and those thick, stable. Was heißt ein Papierdeckel?
Cardboard.
Cardboard.
Close to board. Almost board-like.
Almost board-like sides here.
Paper, yeah.
So I think it could lay a time in the rain and would be still very stable. No? Yeah, Doc Forgay, really recommended. $20. What you can do with it is much more worth than this little money. I love it.
Actually, I'm going to get that because it's a topic for me as well.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Awesome.
If you wait a year, I give it to you.
Yeah. Yeah, I'll translate it into German.
Absolute super.
Cool.
Yeah. Oh, du hast mir nicht mitgedacht.
Was habe ich?
It's from the Austrian Army. They never won a war, but they never get wet. Huh?
Yeah.
It's the half side of a tent. We call it Dackelgarage.
Terrier garage, little dog garage, puppy garage.
Puppy garage. But it keeps you dry. We should be set up before the rain, but okay. Ja, wenn wir das dann irgendwie das so hier oben aufspannen können. The tinder keep is very water resistant, so you could lay it here. I drown it in water and it was still intact and everything dry in it. The wood is already coated. Yeah.
Varnish.
The next item is from Outsee. A company I like quite much. Also this is very water resistant. It's an awesome camping light and you can charge cell phone and much stuff with it, or the surprise in the back here. Don't know if the back stuff is water resistant, we will see. Yeah. But it's the company Outsee. We have shown quite some items from them, all the links to all these products. Sadly not for Stefan, but for everything else is in the description.
That's good.
So, and now, ideal for a rainy day.
What?
I got this. Mm-hmm. And this is a nice light.
Okay. Nice.
3 steps. 1, 2, 3.
No way.
And with also 6,000 or 7,000 milliampere big Kapazität a ventilation. This is the smallest airflow, airspeed, and 30 hours it would run. Maybe better without the light. Don't know exact. You have 4 steps here.
Incredible.
And it's really
some
air.
Definitely. Wow.
And today I thought, because I always search for the bushcraft use, and you could put
fire helper.
For fire making, yes, and instead of everything with your head to make a good airflow in the fire. I like this company, they have many bushcraft and survival stuff. This is...
I love this huge clamp you can put it on.
Yes, absolutely, yeah. You can give it on each table.
The tent pole.
Tent pole, for example, it has a very... It stays stable on the ground.
There's a hook as well on the back.
Yes, you can hang it in your tent. I like to use it in the car. And our apartment is on the highest floor and under the roof, so it's very hot. And I love it to have it, if I cut the video and it's not a rainy day, a sunny day, next to me, and I have this ventilator. So this is a camping item. Here you see the Kapazität.
That's the battery pack.
The battery here. It's also inside here. Here you can charge it, and you can charge it and still use it with light and with this...
Van, sometimes it's cool.
With this van.
Exactly.
good. So, Yeah, oh, great item.
Really quite useful.
Yeah, or to give flies and maybe mosses away. Mm. They don't like this airflow.
Exactly.
It could work. But for camping, for normal camping, or to use it in the car, kids on the bedside, backside, even with the climate.
With the air cool,
With the air cool, it's often hot in the car or while with traffic. So, yeah, I like this item and I thank you to the company wanted to have it and that's why I have to show it. But
I actually think that's pretty great.
It's a good tool. It's a nice item and it works endless.
30 hours.
Yeah, 30 hours the van in the slowest mode. Yeah.
Cool. Wow, that is a surprise item. Yeah. That is definitely the, what has it got?
Thanks for watching to you all. Go out in nature. Sepp Waldhandwerk. Fitt euch. Geht's aus. Goodbye to you.